Well, folks, with a heavy heart that I make this video, and word is just coming around now, officially this time. Leroy Selmon has passed away as of today, this afternoon. It was reported 2 days ago when he had his stroke that he had died, but the reports were false. But as of the thought, he was gonna, maybe there's a small chance he's gonna pull through. But died in Tampa, Florida. Prayers to the entire Selmon family. And Leroy Selmon is one of the all-time greats at Oklahoma. He's a legend. You know, we like to put up statues of Heisman winners, but I'll tell you what, if there's one guy who deserves one, Barry Switzer has stated numerous times he's the best player he's ever played at Oklahoma. Him and his brothers, Dewey and Lucius. So those three, when they all on the field at the same time, my dad's told me stories how dominant they were. Oklahoma was unbeatable in the mid-70s. It's sad. You can make arguments for guys like Peterson and Bradford, for Stoops. You can make guys of like Tom McDonald and Jerry Tubbs and Steve Owens, but Leroy will go down as one of theirs today. He went his first round draft pick for the Buccaneers, their expansion year. One of our only two NFL Hall of Famers from the University of Oklahoma. Just overall, everybody says nothing but nice things about him. And 56 years old, taken away from us too soon. So, what I like to do, I like to share a couple moments, share a clip from at a player salute to Coach Switzer that took place back in 2005, and you'll see what type of telltale story, you'll see what kind of guy Leroy Selmon is, and I'll end it off with an OU chant, a little tribute to arguably the greatest defensive player to ever play at OU. So, we lost Jack Meldrin a few years ago, and, you know, we just suffered through the tragic death of Austin Box, and now another legend from OU leaves us too soon. So I'll leave it at that. Y'all enjoy Boomer Sooner. And before I go, say one more thing. OU fans will understand when I say this. God bless Mrs. Selmon. Y'all have a good one.
You know, as a fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth grade student, in Eufaul, Oklahoma, I had to be probably the luckiest kid in all of America because I had three guys to look to that Coach gave me that picture of what it was supposed to look like. One of them is a fellow they call Big Cat at the University of Oklahoma, Leroy Selmon.
Wow, what a great evening. Gosh, I just truly thank God for being here with you. And that's not cliché for me, that's what I really mean. And I think all of us as players appreciate so much Barry Switzer and what he's done, as you've heard, for each and every one of us. And my story is no different. It comes from the Selmon family, and my brother Dewey is here with me, my brother Lucius sends his regrets for not being, but you know, our family was raised with great work ethics, and so one of us had to be working all the time. So he's working tonight. But he wishes he could have been here and been a part of this. This has been just great, just seeing all of our players, and I was sharing with Dewey the older that we have gotten, our appreciation for the experience at Oklahoma University just gets greater and greater and greater. And we're so thankful, growing up in a little small town, Eufaul, Oklahoma, we did not know what opportunities rested ahead for us. Our parents just tried to instill in us some good values, some solid work ethics, and just do the best that we possibly can and try to be the best people we could possibly be. But we're so excited that they wanted us to go beyond high school if we could. They tried to encourage us to, if you can go to college, go to college and try to get a degree from there and get ready for the rest of your life. And we're so excited when Larry Lacewell showed up in Eufaula, Oklahoma, and was looking at our brother Lucius as a prospect to attend Oklahoma University, and our whole family was so excited about that and so grateful. And Dewey and I, we were real excited about it because, you know, Coach would come down, and on the visits we got to eat real good, and he would take us out with them, and as he was recruiting Lucius, and we'd go to, we never went to, we always ate at home, and we got to go to a little restaurant over there, and so we thought, this is really nice. So we're grateful that Lucius had the courage to make a big transition from a little bitty small town, small school, and come to a major university like the University of Oklahoma. He had the courage to do that, to step out of the boundaries of that community. And he stayed, and we had a chance, Dewey and I, a couple years later, we're being recruited, and we had been up to Oklahoma before just watching games and visiting with Lucius. And one of our first best memories and first memories was the dining hall, the training hall. I said, man, we were all about food. I said, oh man, you know. We went in there with Lucius and went down the line, and there's this big row of food, and I said, you can get all you want. I said, oh my goodness, this is unbelievable. Never seen anything like this. But fortunately, Coach Lacewell returned and recruited Dewey and I as well, and we're so grateful for the opportunity that all three of us had and the experiences that our whole family shared with the University of Oklahoma and with the fans and with our players and Coach Switzer. What an experience it was, a very positive experience. And as you heard already, it goes beyond just teaching us the game of football. And he had a great staff of coaches, and many of them are right here with you tonight. Rex Norris was, our position coach, and he carried the same personality that Coach Switzer did. I mean, we worked hard, prepared us to go out and play our best, put us in positions to win, but we had fun as well. Had a lot of fun. On Fridays, we'd go out and be horsing around out there, and probably almost one of my worst injuries happened one day when we were out there horsing around and with Coach Norris and pulled the groin. And but fortunately, we were able to get it put back together and go out and play that next day anyway. But it's just fun memories like that that we hold dear in our hearts. We know that it comes from the top. We had a great leader in Barry Switzer. He's very genuine. What we experienced as players didn't end when our careers ended at the University of Oklahoma. It extended beyond that, because I too have a true story that indicated that in 1994 as well, when Coach Switzer had just gotten a job with the Dallas Cowboys. Recently, it couldn't have been over a month that he had gotten that position. You can imagine how busy he was and putting together a staff and getting ready for a season. Well, that same year I was being inducted into the GTE Academic All-American Hall of Fame in Washington, D.C. And they had asked us to send out, letters to friends to invite them to come, whoever might want to come. So I included Coach on the list and never expected him to show up. But in the induction ceremony, Coach Switzer and Larry Lacewell came. And, of course, Larry was with the Dallas Cowboys as well. And that's the kind of people that we know. That's the heart of Coach Switzer, and that's the heart of the staff, because it starts from the top and it trickles all the way down. That's the personality and the staff that we had, and we don't take that for granted. And the more that I think about that, the more I appreciate the experience, not only for myself, but my brother Dewey and Lucius and all of us as players had at the University of Oklahoma. It's something that we'll remember forever. And it's just so great to be here this evening, and I'd certainly like to thank the host committee for all the hard work and see all of you here, all these players. My goodness, you look, you realize how fortunate you were. These great, great student athletes. I mean, great men. Not only great players, but great people. And that's what sets the basis for your life. And you look at Joe and Glenn Calmo and gosh, every single one of them is so appreciated. And Coach, we thank you for allowing us to be a part of the Oklahoma experience. It's something that dear to our hearts, and it'll be there forever, I can guarantee you. Thank you.